In this video, first I explain introduction of fast approach and slow working hydraulic circuits. Then after I explain the two types of the fast approach and slow working hydraulic circuit. First one is the meter in type position controls and the second one is the meter out type position control circuits. So first we understand the what is the meaning of fast approach and slow workings. So this fast approach and slow working circuit is used in a various types of the machining machines, okay, like as the milling machines, shaper machines, grinding machines and many more. Okay, so in these machines you know that there is a certain idle times for the tools or a tables. Okay, the tools are moving, tables are moving, but cutting is not done. So this is called as the approach, and when the cutting is done, it is called as the exactly workings. Okay, so when the tool is moving or a table is moving but cutting is not done, it is called as the approach, and this approach is required with the fast speed or a high speed. That's why that's meaning is the fast approach. And the slow working means when the tool and workpiece are come in a contact, means actual operation is start, that is required with the slow speed. That's why this second portion name is the slow workings. Okay, so this fast approach and slow working both are the part of the extension stocks. Okay, so that's why here the written that the fast approach and slow working are the two parts of extension stocks. Means in earlier theory we studied that there is an extension stock, it is not divided in any parts, but in a fast approach and slow working, extension is divided into two part. Okay, first part is called as the fast approach, means during that the piston is moving with the high speed, and in a slow times the piston is moving with the slow speed. How it is possible? For that we are required to use the two control valves. So one control valve is called as the F1 and second control valve is called as the F2. Since the speed of extensions during approach is more and that during working is less, and this circuit is required two flow control valves F1 and F2. Now here you see these figures in between the directional controls wire and the machine component. Here you see this is the cutting tools, this is the table, and on the table you see the workpiece. Okay, and this workpiece is reciprocates due to the double acting cylinders, and this double acting cylinder is the rod end types. Okay, so you know that here the workpiece is fitted and the table is moving up to this tool. At that time we require the higher speed because it is called as the fast approach. But when the workpiece and the cutting tool are come in a contact, means like operation is start, they are required the slow speeds. Okay, that's why this theory name is given fast approach and slow workings. So rate of flow during approach is Q1 plus Q2 is equal to Q. Okay, first we understand here you see that the in between directional controls valves and the hydraulic cylinders, the flow control valve is installed, that is F1, F2, and this is the check valve C. Okay, and here you see this F1 is on or off by using this position controls. Okay, by using this 2x2 directional control valves. So this F1 valve is closed sometimes. When this F1 valve is closed, that we understand later on. Okay, but first time rate of flow during approach means when we require the high speed, it is called as the approach. At that time we require to supply the more oil. Okay, so oil is supplied from the both the flow control valves. Okay, that is the from the flow control valve F1, the oil supplied have the quantity Q1s, and the from the flow control valve F2, oil supply quantity is the Q2, and the summation of the Q1 plus Q2 is known as the Q. Rate of flow during approach stroke is the Q2. Sorry, working stroke is the Q2. Means during the working strokes only F2 is on and F1 is closed. But when this approach is going on, F1 and F2 both are open. That's why we are able to supply Q1 plus Q2 quantity. Okay. So flow control valve F2 is set for the Q2 amount of the discharge, and the flow control valve F1 is set for the Q1 amount of the discharge. Check valve C is used for the retractions at the uncontrolled speeds. Means when the retraction is going on, means the piston is moving from right to left side. At that time, oil present on the left side of the piston is supplied it to the check valve, and from the check valve it is supplied it to the A-ports. Means when the oil is returned, it is not passed from the F1 and F2, it is passed from the check valve and supplied it to the A-port, and from the A-port it is going to the tanks. So here are the three things we use in a declarations valve, that is a flow control valve F1, flow control valve F2, and the check valve. There are two methods to achieve fast approach and slow working in hydraulic systems. First one is the position control circuit. In a position, that is again two type, meter in and meter out. Position control means for position control we use the declaration valve, and the declaration valve is use the 2x2 directional control valves. Second one is the pressure control circuits. Now when the any circuit is based on the pressure, at that time we need to use the sequence valve. Okay, so in a pressure control circuit we use the sequence valve, and in pressure circuit that is again 2 meter in and meter out circuits. Now in this video I explained the first method, that is a position control, and the meter in and meter out type. For the pressure control circuit I make the one separate videos. Now position control circuit use the roller operated declaration valve, and the pressure control circuit use the sequence valve. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to the OHP as well as the other subject of the mechanical engineering. All the OHP various link is provided in descriptions as well as on a card, and for other subject I request to visit the playlist. So first I explain meter in type position control fast approach slow working hydraulic circuits. Now here you see these diagrams. Why its name is the meter in? So generally fast approach and the slow working is required for extension strokes. Okay, and meter in means the declaration valve, means flow control valve F1, F2 and the check valve is installed at the inlet of the extension stroke. That's why it is called as a meter in. In a second type of the meter out, this same thing is installed at the outlet of the extension. Okay, here A port is the inlet for the extensions and B port is the outlet. So when we study in this meter out circuit, okay, at that time this same circuit is transported to this outlet of the extension stocks. So expectation for both A and B means, first A means meter in and second is the meter outs. Okay, so for meter out I separately explain you. First we understand the meter in types. So fast approach and slow working is generally for extension of the cylinder. So first we understand how the extension is going on. Okay, so when the lever of 4x2 DCV is kept on the first positions, right now you see in this figure it is for the first positions. Okay, oil flow from P2A and B2T. Here you see P port is connected with A port, arrow is in upper directions. B port and T port is connected, arrow is in downward direction, means from the B port oil is flowing downward directions, and from the P port oil is going upper direction to the A port. Declaration valve is open in a normal positions, hence the oil is flowed through the flow control valve F1 and F2 both. Okay, so here you see this workpiece is here and tool is there, that is a long distance between them. Okay, so for moving the workpiece to the cutting tools we are required a fast speed. Okay, so oil is supplied from the both the flow control valve. So oil coming from the A port is come here, and it's have the three options: go through F1, F2 and the check valve. But we know that check valve is used only return when the retraction is going on. Okay, so for the fast approach oil is supplied from F1 as well as the F2. This F2 has the fixed flow rates, but F1 is on off by using this 2x2 directional control valves. Okay, so it is this directional control valve is the clamp operated. When this machine portion is pressed, this clamp valve, then this F1 is closed. Okay, so it is set like this. Here you see this distance and the workpiece distance is there. Okay, it is nearly same. So when the workpiece is touch here, at that time this table portion is also pressed this valve, and this table is operate this clamp operated directional control valves, and this F1 valve is closed. Here you see the first position is have the T type symbol. This is for the closed conditions. Okay, so declaration valve is open in a normal positions, hence the oil flow through flow control valve F1 and F2 both. Hence the cylinder is extend with the fast speed, and the tool will approach towards the workpiece with the high speed. As soon as the table comes on the roller of declaration valve, means this portion of the table is come near the declaration valve. And when the tables come in a contact with declaration valve, the declaration valve close, and hence oil can flow through the flow valve F2 only. Hence the speed of the cylinder is reduced. So when this portion of this table is touched to this clamp operated declaration valve, at that time they close the F1, because this first square is moving down and it is closed. Okay, means from the F1 valve flow is coming out, but declaration valve is not supplied in these lines and it is not reached to the cylinders. So this is the complete about the extension stocks. Now second is the retraction stock of the cylinders. For the retractions, the operator is changed the positions of the directional control valves. So when the lever of 4x2 DCV is kept on a second positions, oil can flow from P to B and A to T. So here you see this, the P port is connected with this B and here A pot is connected with this T. So oil flow through the check valve C. So how oil is flow from the check valve C? So first oil coming from the pump is supplied to the B pot, and from the B pot it is go to the cylinder B pot, and piston is start to move left to right. Sorry, right to left. At the same time, so the oil presence on the left side of the piston is coming this A pot, and from the A pot, so here oil have the three options: F1, F2, and the check valve C. So F1 and F2 are closed during that, and the oil is passed through the check valve and then enter in A pot. And from the A pot, here you see A pot is connected with T pot, and from the T pot oil is go to the reservoirs. So it is called as the free flow. Hence the speed of the cylinder is not controlled during the retraction strokes. Now second is the meter out type position control, fast approach and slow working hydraulic circuits. So this is the same things, just according to the name, meter in and meter out. So meter out means the declaration valve means F1, F2C is installed at the outlet of extension stocks. This is the inlet during the extension stocks, and this is the outlet. So this circuit is moving installs at the outlets, and according to that there is a slight change in the designs of the tables and the workpiece. Okay, so you also use the same type of the tables and workpiece that drawn in the last image. Okay, theory is samely written, just there is a change in a flow control valve positions. Okay, so same theory is written, nothing is changed on that. Okay, so I not explain you again, it is a same things. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video and subscribe my channels and share with your friends. And for watching more video, I request to visit the playlist